Hey tribe, it's Ikenna, and this is why you find learning a new language so hard. So there are three main reasons why people find learning a language hard, and I'm gonna go into each and every one of those. All right, so reason numero uno is people have a poor start. They do not start off with the right resources, and it's hard to know what the right resources are. Some people use dictionaries, some people just start speaking from day one, people do all kinds of things, use all kinds of websites, but if you don't have a good program that you're using to start off your language, then that base that you're forming is going to crumble sooner than later. So the program I always use is called Pimsleur, and I actually partnered up with them to actually make this video because I love this program so much. I've used it with Japanese, Russian, Dutch, French, and Chinese, all the languages that I've taught myself. It is invaluable. Honestly, if you are learning a language and you just started or you've kind of failed and you want to kind of get back into it, wherever you're at and you need to start off a language right, I highly recommend you to check out Pimsleur. Basically what it is an audio program where there's lessons, 30 minutes per lesson roughly, and in the beginning of the program you start off with a conversation between two speakers, two native speakers, and you don't really understand much. But by the end of the 30 minutes, you actually understand that first conversation you didn't know, and it's a really, really cool model. It's not too heavy on grammar, it's not too heavy on things that would kind of scare you away from the language. It really is meant to hammer down your pronunciation from day one, get you used to the language, and really just give you the confidence that, hey, I'm actually learning, I'm making progress, I can do this. So definitely go check it out. Right now, if you're American, there's actually a really cool deal going on where basically it's a monthly subscription and you have 7 days where you can try it for free. You can try it for free and see how it works for you, and I highly recommend you to do that. If you are international, that option is not there, but still, I highly recommend you to check the link in the description and check out Pimsleur because it is my go-to for everyone. My brother-in-law just asked me, yo, I'm going to Thailand, what should I use? I recommended him Pimsleur, so highly recommend that.
Yes, and by the way.
Sí, y a propósito.
I have to study right now.
Tengo que estudiar ahora mismo.
So once you have that good starter program to start off that language, to give you a solid base, to give you that confidence, what you have to manage next is the second pitfall people kind of get into, which is having bad myths or negative myths or bad expectations in their head. And what I mean by this is you go and you've been studying this language for 3 months and you see people that speaking the language and you go sit next to them and try to eavesdrop and you can't understand anything. And you're just like, what? I've been learning this for... You freak out and you just get really depressed and you're like, I thought I was actually progressing. And listen, there's a lot of expectations people have. People think they can learn it super quick. People think they will never be able to learn it because it takes too much time. People think they can only learn if they're children. That's not the case. I learned 6 languages in actually the last 6 years, all as an adult, and I was raised only speaking English. People have so many different expectations, but just I would recommend be modest. Know that it's gonna take some time, it's gonna be a bit difficult, you're not gonna be able to understand everyone speaking everything, that you know they're walking by you and you're like a superhero just, ooh, I heard that. No, come on. Be reasonable, but also be aware of the fact that, you know, you might have heard this about languages and this about languages, and really kind of go backtrack and be like, the thing I heard about learning languages, is it true? And do some research, really researching your language that you're learning and other people's experiences with it is very, very powerful if you want to dispel popular, you know, pseudoscience myths about learning languages. So the last one, okay? So the last reason people have a hard time learning a language is they lack confidence. And lacking confidence is deadly, and there's a reason why. I mean, I understand it personally. When I was learning my first language, I always had the feeling of, am I wasting time? Am I actually gonna be able to do this? I might not be able to do this. I'm not gonna be able to do this. And that is the worst feeling to have. Personally, for me, the feeling that I'm probably just wasting time. And if you've had that feeling or you have that feeling right now, let me just tell you that if you go through with it, if you're consistent, you will learn the language and it will click for you after some time. It might not come within the first 3 months or the first 6 months, but you definitely will see progression and you need to keep with it. If you lack confidence and you're always doubting yourself, that can lead to you not being consistent, which can lead you to not practicing, which can lead you to feeling like this language is no good, or you're no good, and which ultimately leads to quitting. You do not want that. Have some confidence in yourself, because at the end of the day, how hard learning a new language is isn't dependent on how much time it's gonna take or how hard it's commonly thought to be. How hard learning a language is really depends and is based upon your self-confidence. If you lack it, it's gonna be very hard. And obviously, if you lack the resources or the right resource to start you off, it's gonna be very hard too, which is why I recommend Pimsleur. Literally my go-to program, like I said, link in the description. And yeah, just to recap, guys, make sure you expel those bad myths, research your language that you're learning, research other people's experiences with it, know that it's going to take time, and know that you really do need to be confident. This is Ikenna signing out. Thank you so much for watching. If you're interested in how I learn my languages and my method personally, I did write a book. It's called Fluency Made Easy. It is in the description below. But thank you guys so much for watching. I know I've been away for a while. We just hit 100,000 subscribers. I am so super over the moon about that. So I'm doing a Q&A soon. So if you have some questions, leave them down below. And thank you guys so much. Peace.